Yeah, let me show you that article. That's a Daily Beast article.
Yeah. does it watch it clearly. Control the media. We have too much this, we have too much that. And me, apologetically.
There's with the media, so Paul Joseph Watson before selling out. A shocking, you know, imagine my shock that that thinking he used to cover this stuff and never does it. Total sellout. Total sellout. Okay, so now. Oh, wait, before dinner. So that was him before and after. Now all he does is he's got so many videos that he's bashing ISIS as if Israel's not supporting ISIS. And he's not going to turn good because, one, he has a video of this. He's already denounced all the things he used to say and says he doesn't believe in conspiracies anymore. And apparently the conspiracy he's talking about is 9/11 and Zionism because that's what he doesn't cover anymore. So, you know, you do maps.
People.
forum, which allows us to inform us on the cost of funding, and that's why you know it's powerful to hold contained with Clippers. That's the trick, too, that they very often serve Washington. You know, there's a gap in the legal regime. There are techniques that extremists have used online. They're like hate speech, like being popular, like doxing and swatting. It's not that I ever believe. They're not covered by existing laws that need to be. Because, you know, the school principal says, what's that? Well, they're not even just how he goes. But then, in fact, the abuse of it can be far worse than anything visible. So, you know, we need legislators to catch up and fill some of the gaps.
Catch up, do more with filling the gaps. They always said that. They need to do more. And notice how he's using, like, oh, we need to protect the children. Oh, the poor kids are getting bullied. So we need more control and enforcement. Use AI, machine learning algorithms to track down all of the quote-unquote anti-Semitic conspiracy theories for the children, for the bullying, for the doxing. Doxing, swatting, and childhood bullying are different issues than...
Criticizing being called an anti-Semite, so they benefit on the back end too, because it was Jewish people that came up with this
Hawks still today operate as a covert team. I love that. Even Israelis think that they're working behind the scenes, but left and right, divided by the kind of like the Bushes and the Clintons being so close, or Michelle Obama and Bush, you know, all part of the club. Trump's right along there with them taking the photo. So when you see that perspective, when you see this, that they were a covert team, and that they're crafting strategy with a maverick intimacy born behind enemy lines and clubby elitism that eclipses their markedly divergent personalities in politics. So, like WWF, their friend behind the scenes, but then they go and pretend to fight. So here, quoting in Saunders' History of the Union, Netanyahu and himself, speaking at the 1997 Sayeret-Mescal reunion, reflecting on lessons it had taught him about seeing through long-term goals. Quote, there are missions that are scheduled months or even a year or two in advance. Netanyahu said, I argue that they operate and plan decades, if not quarter centuries or centuries in advance with their plans. So, and they've been trying to rebuild the temple for hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years. That's long-term goals, so they don't give up. So, it gives my meaning to this Netanyahu tweeting out stuff like this with Ewing Barak and Soros. When there was, and remember, I've done March of Desire and God's Chosen People, that Ewing Barak and maybe Netanyahu were instrumental in pushing for the war on terror after 9/11. Ewing Barak was in BBC World Studios, and Netanyahu was all over the news and in Congress and lobbying and pushing and advocating and lying and pressuring us to go and launch this war that he had planned a decade before.
Soros is an anti-Israel scumbag, but you're fully aligned against him. The point is, it's the largest pro America.
Okay, so Soros is anti-Israel, that's true, I'll give him that. But even one of the shrewd Israel blow them off the map, like Alex Jones likes to throw straw hands out there to make it sound crazy. So Alex Jones claims that he's just pro-America, you know, he's pro-America, but he endorses and supports the latest single man, lackey, Trump, 24-hour World War II Trump coverage. Trump, but Trump is more popular in Israel. He's an Israeli first president, and he is more people like him in Israel than America. Trump, I think, did 98% of the vote in Iran in the Israeli elections, and he also attacked said that the Democratic Party hates Jews. So this issue is a wedge issue in this upcoming election, a huge one. BDS and anti-Semitism are a lot of men have been covering leading up to this crescendo. Trump tells Republican donors that Democrats hate Jews. He says 98% in his vote would support him for prime minister. He's trying to help Netanyahu right now get reelected. They've got huge billboards of them shaking hands together, and Netanyahu probably vote them because they know Netanyahu is the key to control America. So why would they do that? Israelis love Trump more than almost any other nation, poll showed. This was October 2nd, 2018. 69% of Israelis expressed confidence in Trump as president, compared to 28% in the UK, 30% in Japan, and who knows what it is around America, but I'm sure it's not 69%, that's for sure. And Times of Israel, January 2018, Israel among few countries that like Trump more than Obama poll finds. So he is the Israeli candidate. That's why in CPAC, the conservative American, MAGA America Press, supposedly, passed a Republican conference, there was more moral Israel great again hats than MAGA hats. And there was more presentations and panels and conferences and booths about Israel and Jerusalem than any type of America First policy issues. And you can see the people there too as well. So there's Faith Gorley with the 666 symbol. She's trolling, apparently. Who knows? Maybe she's turning over a new leaf now that she's not a rebel anymore. She's on a channel that has 4,000 subs. Not an endorsement. I was wondering because she's kind of saying something, but not going far with it. This was from Build Israel Great Again Hats. You can see here, the house for the Prophet of Jerusalem. And when you put on glasses, it doesn't take much. You can see the glasses really well. CPAC is just another APAC, so Republican America First. You got APAC, you got CPAC, you got DOA, you know, but to talk about any of the influence and foreign allegiance is unacceptable to even mention, yeah. Again, another means, you know, this is an exaggeration. Trump is making Israel great again. The biggest promise that they always brag about him keeping, you know, he kept his promises, he moved the embassy. Now, I don't care, that's not good. The Trump train is going to Israel.